What is going on, everyone? Welcome back. As always, my name is Zena, and I'm coming at you here over on YouTube to showcase something very special, making a grand return from Blackside Customs. I'm sure a lot of us have seen recently Borderlands. The game series has been kicking around quite a bit in media as of late. It had a movie came out. It wasn't too successful because the people that created that movie didn't really keep up to date with the source material of the game, kind of did their own thing. A lot of people weren't too happy about it. However, Borderlands, the game developers, have recently come out with a new trailer for a new game coming around, so Borderlands has been kicking around quite a bit more popularity as of late. For those unaccustomed with video games, Borderlands is sort of this unique sci-fi-ish apocalyptic style game, and has its own comic book style cartoon look. It's a very unique blend of a game for a lot of us that grew up playing it. Borderlands is really fun. If you're not too well known for video games, don't worry about that. The whole point is that Blackside Customs used to do back in the day a Borderlands finish to some of their blades, making it sort of a mix of cartoony meets real world in a knife form. And they've recently brought it back as of late with two different configurations. So I'm going to have this video along with another one. Both are about the same design. The only difference is going to be their aesthetic along with the color choices that they did for the Borderlands. This one in front of me is a Strider design custom, or the SLCC drop point blade with Borderlands icebreaker finish featuring Magnacut steel and black G10 handle. For those unaccustomed with Blackside's fixed blades, they are extremely comfortable in the hand because they are fully designed to be perfect all around for everyday carry tasks, but also for collection and things of that nature. The Strider, aka Strider Knives, has been a very iconic knife company throughout time, and their signature thing is a certain shape, which I'm sure you're seeing here in this handle. Their folders, reminiscent to this fixed blades handle here, fits very comfortably in the hand because usually at the back end of the handles, it sort of has this nice little pommel area that really holds onto the palm, so when you're gripping them, you have a lot of control out of their blades, and with collaboration of Blackside, the Strider fixed blade is meant to bring the folder from Strider into the fixed blade world. Hence why we see it sort of get its own unique new look. The handle gets shortened down, bigger blade, but you still have perfect control and very well comfortability with the edge. Now the icebreaker, sort of a unique character in Borderlands, is reminiscent of a bluish and purple color tones, hence why they matched it with the blade. As you can see with these like white lines and black lines, very reminiscent to like a comic book cartoon look. So it has its own unique flair to it. And with the black G10, there's a lot of grip in this, so even with its full ergonomic handle, it even adds more texture to it. So say if your hands are wet or you're wearing gloves or anything of that nature, there's plenty more control with that grip, even more so than just its full design, it's by itself. Also featuring a paracord hole or a lashing hole, in case you want to tie something on there, in case you want to add some paracord beads or anything like that. I personally like to do a sort of unique outdoor-ish bracelet. So when you do like a paracord bracelet and stuff, you can actually attach them to the knives, so that way you can go around your wrist and you have even more control over your fixed blades. A lot of videos out there how to do it. I personally like to do that a lot with my fixed blades. Makes it a lot more comfortable, especially if you're doing it for like outdoor tasks and things of that nature. You even have more control. Say if you do slip, which you're not going to with this one, but say if you do slip, it's not going to go anywhere because it will be attached to your wrist with a paracord loop. Now this is fully done in Magnacut steel and a drop point finish blade, and is a full 6.9 inch overall. So it's got a 3.7 cutting edge and about 4.3 overall for the tip to scale size. It is a full tang design, so no rat tang or anything crazy like that. It fully goes right through that handle and weighs about 4.8 and then about 6.4 with its sheath, which is a full kydex design featuring Blackside's custom little signature pin. Doesn't come with any hardware, however, because of that reason, it's fully customizable. So say if you wanted to add any sort of fanciness to the kydex, belt loops, things of that nature, you can always attach it because they leave plenty of room for different configurations. These are pretty cool. I personally used to love Borderlands back in the day growing up, so it's really cool to see that in the knife world, especially because of the chaotic nature that those games entail. I'm personally excited that another game's coming out. Wasn't too big a fan of the movie. Some people have their own opinions, you know. Some people enjoy the movie, some people didn't. But it's awesome to see a cartoon-designed blade kicking around now. We will have another video on a different one, very reminiscent to some of the old colors from Borderlands, so keep an eye out for that one. Like and subscribe to keep up to date with more videos as they come out. Hit that little notification bell. It will let you know when more videos come out. It'll notify you. And if you enjoy the content, hit us up on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, where we do upload daily. As always, I want to thank everyone that's been subscribing to the channel. Thank you so much. Thank you for tuning in, as always. And we will catch you in the next one, folks.